More dovish signals from the Philippine Central Bank on a possible rate cut by August. Banco Central Governor Eli Remolona spoke Monday at an economic forum where he reiterated the likely timeline for easing the key borrowing rate of 6.5%, as he called the latest inflation figure of 3.7% better than expected. Manila's monetary chief says the fight to bring down inflation is now at the last mile, while also cautioning against overdoing rate cuts.
Almost there, but we have to be more careful than before, because there's a risk we might overdo it. There's a risk we might cause a loss of unnecessary loss of output, and we want to minimize that risk.
Senator Nancy Binay files an ethics complaint against her colleague Alan Peter Cayetano. It stems from their tense exchange during the recent hearing on the new Senate building. Binay cited Cayetano's name-calling and allegation that she fed the media questions during her radio interviews as basis for the complaint. The two lawmakers had a heated back and forth during the hearing, with Binay insisting the cost of the new Senate building was not 23 billion pesos, and Cayetano countering by citing records from Binay's former committee staff that show the estimate including the cost of the land. Binay now hoping that the Senate Committee on Ethics and Privileges will tackle her complaint when Congress resumes on July 22. Philippine Finance Chief Ralph Recto not expecting the Supreme Court to issue a temporary restraining order against the government's controversial rice tariff reduction. Speaking at the Economic Journalists Association of the Philippines' annual economic forum, Recto said Filipinos can expect rice prices to improve immediately as the government anticipates an average of 10% reduction in rice prices for the rest of the year. Agriculture groups sought a TRO against the executive order that slashed rice import levies, as they argue it was issued without public consultations. BDO kicks off its 5 billion peso fixed rate sustainability bond offer. This is the third peso-denominated green bond of the Philippine lender after its 63 and 52 billion peso bond offering early this year and in 2022, respectively. Tenor is a 1.5 years, while the rate per annum is at 6.32%. The offer period is until July 19th, listing on the 24th. Proceeds of this will be used to finance assets in its sustainable finance framework and diversify its funding sources. Security Bank also issuing bonds to support its lending activities. It set the minimum size of its offering to 5 billion pesos to be taken out of its 200 billion peso bond and commercial papers program. The bonds carry a 5-year and 1-month tenor with a fixed rate of 5.7% per annum. Offer period is until August 13, with PDEX listing on the 20th of that month. And finally, new president at First Metro Investment Corporation, home to some of our esteemed market analysts here on the program. FMIC named Anthony Ocampo to the post and also as director to succeed Mr. Jose Patricio Dumlao, who had retired from the company. Ocampo brings with him decades of experience in corporate and investment banking from his time at the Metro Bank Group. He was previously the head of global network banking under Deutsche Bank's corporate and investment bank group.